Hello everyone. So we are seeing in the news from the last few days, America is burning. Mainly Washington DC has been targeted. The riots reached up to White House. The problem created for the world's supreme leader, the world's supreme power, the American president. America is under crisis. That I am going to discuss. America is under crisis. What happened? There was a person called as George Floyd. So the American medical report, the postpartum report told that it was a homicide. He was died because of pulmonary artery disease. That means he was being pressed down because of absence of oxygen entering into him. He was being killed. From this clear evidence, we can tell that yes, he was being killed by a police officer. So this created riots. And total America is under boiling because the people who are with discontent, yes, there is some racial feeling which is still prevailing in American departments. Now it resurfaced. So how it got resurfaced? Recent death of African American George Floyd. Already discontent African Americans. There are discontent people who are feeling that yes, there is a racial feeling is going on. The African Americans have been discriminated by the white Americans. A lot of evidences. The report tells that annual report of the Department of Police of United States of America mentions that 80% of the people who are being killed under the police brutality are black Americans, not white Americans. Why is it so? Which is continuing since decades. This report proves that yes, there is some sort of discrimination towards the black Americans. Number three, whites also joined the movement. Whites, the liberal whites, the whites who fought for the justice, they are also for the justice for the black Americans. They are also against the white racism which is prevailing, the white ethnocentrism which is prevailing in American departments. Mainly it is because of the police brutality, the law enforcement agencies brutality. Law enforcement agencies personnel also claiming discrimination against black Americans, the black Americans who are working in the departments. They are also claiming that yes, we are subjected to discrimination. So this racism, the racial discrimination, the ethnocentric feeling that we are great, we are white people, we are great, we are Americans, we are white Americans, you are black Americans. That ethnocentric feeling led to racial conflict in the earlier times, which led to civil war also. So this is white versus black we can compare in our Indian context. This white versus black we can compare in our Indian context with the comparison with our caste system. We had a rigid caste hierarchy. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. The Shudras are not allowed to grow. Every time the lower caste people need to oblige to the upper caste people. The lower caste people doesn't have any freedom to do their own choice. They don't have any option. They have to follow what the upper caste people are doing. So there is caste discrimination is there, which is similar to racial discrimination, which is present in United States of America. Rigid caste hierarchy. Upper caste domination. Yes, only we people should rule. Only we people can do anything. The lower caste people should not do. Why? Because it's not your cup of tea. The same how there is a white supremacy, similarly there is Brahmin supremacy. Similarly there is upper caste supremacy. It's not only the Brahmin, it is the upper caste supremacy. So for every state there are upper castes are there. There is diversity in upper castes, dominations in different states. Upper caste domination is very, very common. For example, I will tell you one incident of a case study which is called as Ranveer Sena. A group of Bhumihar community in Bihar, which evolved like a very strong and very great organization, very great in number organization, which is a dominant organization, which is against the lower caste people. If any lower caste people are growing, they will not allow the lower caste people to grow. They will not allow the lower caste people for education. They will not allow the lower caste people to pursue the higher education. If we inform this issue to the Ranveer Sena that there is one lower caste family or there is one SC caste family who is preparing for civil services or who is aspiring to grow, the Ranveer Sena will come and attack. So they don't allow the lower caste groups to grow. They believe that only the upper caste people should be on the top, the lower caste people should be down. Ranveer Sena is a caste-based militia functioning as an upper caste. That is upper caste landlord group targeting lower caste groups. So by which the discrimination is prevailing. It is banned by the Bihar government in 1995 only, but today also under the carpet the Ranveer Sena is present. We have to applaud the great people like B.R. Ambedkar, because coming out from this sort of discrimination and evolving and becoming the father of the Indian constitution. So at least in this 21st century, we believe that the caste-based discrimination and race-based discrimination should come to an end. Thank you.